on a touchdown. I'ma burn it all to the ground. Make sure the whole world feel it. That's just how I'm feeling. Big boss, I'm a big boss. Up north, brick route. I got the pump that'll make you jump. Don't you ever get it crisscross. Don't you ever get it crisscross. Don't you ever get it crisscross. I got the pump that'll make you jump. Don't you ever get it crisscross. Bet against me, that's a big love. You about to find out what the count. I find then I get low. Lift off. It ain't nothing to cut the off. Stop frying, don't let it get soft. Covered in yolk, in yolk. Wonder why I got the whole world pissed off. That's just how I'm feeling. Dog, that's just how I'm feeling. When I touch down, I'ma burn it all to the ground. Make sure the whole world feel it. That's just how I'm feeling.
City that's played host to 10 Super Bowls. Here's a look inside the Superdome in New Orleans.
This is what it looked like just a moment ago in the heart of New Orleans. Folks, there's no place for this noise to go in the Superdome. It is loud, and these fans are ready for football as their Saints get ready to do battle with the Philadelphia Eagles. Seems like we were just starting training camp, but here we are in October, and off we go on EA Sports. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. And a little touch pass on the jet sweep. And that is the kind of tackling they want to see all game, as he'll lose yardage to start things out.
Well, I think the hope is, you know, with a touch pass like that, then maybe you catch the defense off guard, but they were all over that one.
And it is the kind of play that works better against certain defenses. And this clearly was the wrong one to run into. Really nice job getting him down behind the line of scrimmage.
Here's a throw to his running back. It's complete. And they're able to get this one across the 35.
Well, I think when they look at their offense, they think to themselves, weapons, weapons everywhere. And they want to move the ball around. They want to spread it to different people. But you absolutely know they want to get this man involved as well. And that's what they just did on that play.
Miles Sanders, first carry of the game. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
Not a whole lot there. The defense was ready, it looked, for that run-pass option.
You get the sense that next time he has that opportunity, he may keep it himself and get to the perimeter. Probably owes his back a little bit of an apology on that one, huh?
Second down, back to Sanders. Nowhere to go that time. He maybe got a yard up to the 40.
But now they're in a spot that every team tells us when we have our production meetings they don't want to be in, third and long. That's because those back-to-back running plays just didn't accomplish a whole lot.
Throwing on third down, Watson. That's caught by the big tight end, Dallas Goedert. And out of bounds on the other side of midfield at the 45. So in Saints territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 45-yard line. Watson, a little touch pass on the jet sweep. And he's going to be met at about the 43.
That's a nice job there defensively, being able to diagnose that little touch pass. They saw it coming, converged on him before he could get much out of it.
It's a second down run with Sanders. Shedding the tackle. And some room to run now. And he goes down, but not before getting this inside the 25.
Just a terrific run there, Charles, from a running back who is so compact and powerful. And that strength was on display there.
Yeah, and this could be a sign of what this defense is in for, because you know all week long the coaches were preaching to the defense, you've got to be able to wrap up against a back like him, or he can make you pay. Technique, technique, technique.
Right back to Sanders on first down. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8 yard gain, second and two. The impressive opening drive continues, and just space being created by those guys up front.
We're seeing this the same way, aren't we? We are seeing an offensive line, as this game gets started, as it starts to unfold, that they are dominating the line of scrimmage.
Just a gain of a yard there, and now it'll be third down.
I haven't met a defense coordinator yet that thinks second and two is a fun situation to try and defend. Playbook is wide open for an offense partner.
Nice job holding to one after that 8 yard pickup on first down.
And he is going to have an Eagles first down. At least it would appear that way. He didn't get it by much, but yes, they do get the conversion on third and one.
On first and 10, it's Sanders. And he'll get this one down to about the 10-yard line. A gain of three, second down.
He's had success on this drive, but not on this play.
Finally, they bowed up defensively. I think they were determined not to let him take it pretty much all the way down the field.
Yeah, it looks like they handled their run responsibilities correctly this time. What we call them, run fits, everyone was in the right place.
Only a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a third down.
Remember, as they try to run the ball down here, Charles, this is the number two rush defense in the league.
So do you accept the challenge up front? Get the offensive line together, get your tight end in the ball game, and say, I don't care that they're number two. Let's go ahead and show them that we can run the ball anyway.
Touchdown! A great play there. His fourth touchdown on the year. And the Eagles drive right down the field and score the opening drive. Elliott good on the extra point, and it's now a 7-0 game.
Saints nothing.
Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Play fake here on first down. Oh, this is going to be caught along the sidelines. Probably shouldn't have been caught. He's going to lose yardage there. So that'll be no better than an incompletion. And that'll make it second and 10. Here's Kamara on the read option. And he's going to get about 7 yards on that one, up to around the 33.
Now, this defense for the Eagles, they were fantastic a week ago in that win over Houston.
And I'm eager to see the game plan and trying to attack them this week, because when you take it away four times through interceptions, what do you do now when you go into a game? Do you decide you can't throw the ball? Do you try and run it more? Or do you tell your quarterback, make sure you see your guys open before you deliver?
And he is going to have a Saints first down as they get five there on third and two. They'll give to Kamara here on the option.
And he's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of nine on first down.
A nice run here early on. It doesn't take a great play caller to realize you want to establish a guy of his caliber with runs like this early, because they'll pay dividends as the game progresses.
The previous run, good for nine. Here's second and a yard. Trying the left side with Kamara. And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. It'll be a loss of a full 3 yards there, and it also brings up third down.
He'll look to throw. Out of the backfield, that's complete to Kamara. They'll wind up losing a couple yards here on the play, and it'll be fourth down.
Excuse my snarkiness here, but isn't the idea of completing a pass supposed to mean you get downfield and gain yards?
Especially on third down.
Yeah, that one. How about the defense? Figured that one out in a big way. Yeah, they completed it all right and lost yardage.
7 yards on the return after a punt of 39. And the Eagles will have it, taking over first and 10. The Eagles' offense set to begin their next drive. They have to be thrilled with that first drive that got them the touchdown. Now they'll be looking to make it a two-score advantage here on the road.
And you know, they spent all week in practice, in meetings, talking about taking an early advantage. Being the road team, going up a score, that takes the crowd out of the game and puts some doubt in the minds of their opponents.
After one, 7-0 on EA Sports. On second down now, it's Sanders, and he'll get it up near the 35, right at the 34 here. 45 yards rushing now on 8 carries for him so far. From the 34 now, here's first and 10. They'll run with Sanders. And he'll be stopped right at midfield.
Gosh, when you've got Deshaun Watson, Charles, executing a run-pass option, that puts the defense in a tough spot, does it not?
It does, and what I liked is that you called me this week watching your own video, your own tape, and you said, I think the runner's going to pop a few this week because of what we've seen from Deshaun Watson. His ability to get to the corner, that's where the focus will go.
And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35.
They're making it look easy out there. Another first down. So far on this drive, let me do this little bit of math here. 4 plays, 3 first downs.
That's a pretty good recipe for success.
And the result here, a pickup of 8. Leaves them with 2 to go on second down.
It's a game of matchups, and that's why you take your receivers and move them around a bunch, especially your best guys. And when they work out of the slot, you often hear the coaches talk about how great it is because it gives you a two-way go. You can break out or you can break in. That makes it hard to defend.
And this won't be enough to pick up the first. A gain of 2, 3rd and 1. Pretty good job defensively. Thought he was going to get it, but they knew where that marker was and they stopped him just short of it.
What it does is emphasize that strategic football and situational football is not just played on the offensive side, is it? Defense understanding, as you noted, where the first down marker was and making sure they didn't get there.
And that looked like some pretty easy yardage there right up the gut.
And he's a guy that has some height to him. So when you don't have to drop a shoulder or create or get through contact or trash, makes it a lot easier to stay upright, see the field, and make a run as we just saw there.
A gain of 8 there on the 8th play of the drive. Ahead of the chains now, 2nd and 2. To the left there and complete to the tight end Goddard. And the Eagles are going to have a first and goal coming up as the tackle made at the 3-yard line.
A lot of tight ends just use their size and their strength, try to occupy some space and kind of body people away and catch the football. But not this guy. He's a refined route runner. Makes me wonder if he took some dance classes in his background with his footwork.
And he'll go backwards, losing yardage to the 5. This defense not fooled one bit on that touch pass.
And this has become one of those kind of in vogue plays, you know, kind of like the shuffle pass was a few years ago. This one never got off the ground, but you understand.
And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Philadelphia. Miles Sanders, his 6th touchdown of the season. And the Eagles add on to their lead. Elliott Good with a PAT, and that'll make the score 14-0.
Saints nothing.
Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Getting set for their next drive, the New Orleans offense.
They're staring at a two-touchdown deficit, 14-0 the score as they regroup with first and 10. It's a pickup of 4, and it'll bring up second down.
They'd love to just strike back with a touchdown right here, and if it's a long play, so be it. But the main goal, get a couple of first downs, run some plays, run some clock, allow their defense to get a chance to catch their breath, settle down, and relax a little bit after they just gave up a score.
The throw over the middle, taken in.
When you're struggling on offense, you're looking for anything possible to get you going. Sometimes you do it like basketball teams that don't normally press. You put a press on, bring people to life, make them move a little bit quicker. Maybe that'll help them as they head towards the half.
So here's a first and 10 at the 38. He'll drop to throw. Man open left side, it's Williams. 3 yards the gain there, second down.
It's vitally important to wrap him up immediately, because if you let that big guy get a head of steam up, boy, then you've got real trouble trying to get him down.
But they're able to hold him to a short gain on first down. Here's a second and 7. That's complete to his running back, Kamara. And the play goes nowhere, losing yardage back near the 40 at the 39. It'll be a loss of a couple on the play, so now third down coming up. Two minutes to play, first half, it's 14-0. And we'll remind you that coming up at halftime, we'll join Jonathan Coachman and the gang in Orlando. Coach will have stats and scores from the early games going on here around the NFL. All right, rifles one, and that's going to be intercepted. Snags it for the pick. Then they take possession 2 yards away from midfield at the 48-yard line.
Well, that's a drive killer right there. Not a really confident throw either. This one was kind of up for grabs, and it's going to come down the hands of the wrong team.
They'll run on first down. It's Sanders. Fast footwork by Sanders. And he's got this down a yard or two shy of the 40 before he's out of bounds. 87 yards rushing for him so far as his terrific season continues here. So they'll come up after the gain of 7 on a 2nd and 3. Watson, a little touch pass on the jet sweep. And he gets this down inside the 35 before going out of bounds. 7 yards there and a first down.
And this is just a little touch pass. They send the receiver in motion, just kind of tap it forward to him. Now, it doesn't turn into a huge play, but they do pick up a first down, a nice consistent gain.
Now a first down throw, Watson. Throw left side, complete. That's Sanders. And that play went nowhere. Losing yardage. It'll be back at the 36. But despite the completion, they're going to wind up losing 3 there. 2nd down. Got to give some credit there defensively. They snuffed out that screen early on 1st down.
Really read it well, didn't they? Because they didn't bring the pressure that they expected. They covered all the passing lanes. So once you see it break down as the passer, I think in this situation, you're throwing it at the feet of your back to make sure no one picks it off, or you throw it away, throw it over the sideline. Don't try and freelance and try and make a bigger play. There's really no one else running a pattern that should be open. Press coverage on the outside, and for defenders, that's the ultimate risk-reward. If you take the risk, can you reward yourself by keeping them on the line of scrimmage? But no, not on that one. Got the step on them. Now it's just a matter of laying the ball out there for him to go get it.
And now they're inside the 10 as he's brought down at the 9. The Eagles going to take the first of their timeouts as they get it right at the 32nd mark of this first half. Working with a 2nd and 4. Get it, get it. Running right, here's Sanders. And he'll take it into the end zone for an Eagles touchdown. Miles Sanders with his second touchdown here in this first half. And the Eagles add 6 to their lead. So simple math here in the first half. They've had 3 drives offensively, and they have scored every time, and they've got the lead.
Well, whenever we talk about adjustments, we usually talk about an offense making adjustments, right? This is all about the defense. They've got to figure out some way, somehow, to slow them down. Do they blitz a little bit more? Do they play more zone coverage? Right now, they don't know where to go because they're hitting them in every direction.
Now, after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. And here comes a return from the middle of the end zone. At their own 25-yard line. The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. And with 25 seconds to go, we'll see how they want to play this. And he's going to get a good gain of 9 here, up to the 34. Now we'll get a quick timeout called by New Orleans, number 2, as the clock will stop with 20 seconds to go in the first half. Maybe a good spot to take a shot. Here, 2nd and 1 yard from the 34. The play action fake. They'll look to throw. They'll get this out to Kamara. And he gets this up across the 35 before he's out of bounds. It's been a very one-sided game so far. They got to change what they're doing right now, don't they? You can't wait till the halftime speech to make an adjustment.
No, you can't, because if you're doing it right, you're adjusting from series to series, and they need a big adjustment here to try and put some points on the board.
Yeah, he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40.
And I like the idea here. Get the ball in his hands, even if it's in the passing game. 3 catches a week ago, and he does a nice job here to pick up yardage.
This offense finding its legs now. Here's another 1st and 10. He'll look to throw. And that is incomplete, stopping the clock with 5 seconds to go.
They've given up a few first downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
So on 2nd down, the field goal unit is on here as they try to get 3 before half. This will be from 56 yards out. And this one will not get there. It's off to the left anyway. It's no good. So we've reached halftime here, and it's our visitors, the Eagles, leading this one. As we send you on over to Orlando for Jonathan Coachman in our EA Sports Halftime Report. Take it away, Coach. All right, Coach, thanks very much. Fine work as always as we welcome you back for quarter number 3. The Saints going to go on offense first, and they trail here as we begin quarter number 3. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Getting set for their next drive, the New Orleans offense. And that first half, one to forget really on both sides of the ball. They got to find some way to string something together here, don't they?
Yeah, they're down big right now. So as you mentioned, trying to find something to string together, get some consistency, something sustained, maybe calm their whole team down and find a way to get back in this one.
Yeah, because right now you're down big, you're being shut out. Let's see if this is the drive that kind of kickstarts them. So from the 36 now, 1st and 10. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. 12 yards there, good for a Saints 1st down. Boy, an effective play there, getting their wideouts involved in the run game.
And what they're always hoping on that type of a play, that they can get to the end of the line and have a chance to turn it upfield as he did there. That means they controlled the blocking and took care of the defensive end or the outside linebacker to give him that lane.
And I guess I need to clarify, I said getting their wideouts involved in the run game, but of course that was actually a pass as he popped it forward.
They'll look to throw now on first down. Oh, he dropped it. And that's pretty indicative of the way this one's gone.
Another attempt, another incompletion. And when I look at the scoreboard and where we are in this game, it comes to mind that they have to start getting the ball in the hands of their playmakers. Throw it to the guys that maybe can take a short pass and turn it into a long gain or make people miss downfield. They've got to have points. And the guys who can put the ball in the end zone, they're the ones that need to touch the ball.
And across the midfield stripe into Eagle territory.
44 yards rushing for him now to this point.
That was a really nice run there to bring up third and short. After the incompletion on first down, it's awfully nice to have a running back that you can hand it to and put you back in a good situation.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. They'll drop to throw.
Oh, not sure he saw the linebacker there as that's batted down and incomplete.
And that's a nice job there because you've got to play the ball, not the man when in coverage. That'll keep you away from a lot of needless penalties, and he's able to knock that one away.
I guess they figure they got to start taking some chances. Here's a big one in this third quarter as he'll go for it on fourth down. They'll set up a throw. Throw right side, complete to Williams. And he will have a first down here at about the 40.
We always talk about big-time players make big-time plays in big-time moments. I think that fourth down qualified. That was a heck of a throw.
On first down, he'll drop to throw. Complete. Smith has it. Well, he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30.
I don't know what they talked about at halftime. Whatever it was, it worked. They look like a different team here in the third quarter.
Yeah, I doubt that there are very many trash cans that got kicked over that type of a speech. I think what they did was they analyzed what worked in the first half, what didn't, and figured out a better game plan.
Still in search of their first touchdown of the game, but they're on the move. First and 10. Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. Rolling to his right. And he'll take this beyond the line of scrimmage as he slides to a hole. Give him a couple on the scramble. It's second down.
Now, how about that play? He took a possible negative and turned it into positive yardage and slid down to avoid taking a big shot. Excellent job getting down and avoiding the big hit.
Here's Kamara on the read option.
And he'll get a couple here down to the 22.
Not too many offenses want to turn down long drives, but when you're down what they are, they've got to pay it off with some points.
Third down now. Those last two plays indicative of how things have gone for them. Just nowhere to go on the ground and struggling to put up points.
He's got the first down inside the 10. Touchdown, Saints! Alvin Kamara with touchdown number 7 on the year. And the Saints are able to cut into this lead as they score on the opening drive of the second half. Point after, right down the middle. And the lead will be cut down to 14. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive.
And they were terrific in the first half, built up a sizable lead, and it's just been cut into a bit following the opening drive score on the other side. But this,
and now off to the races, down the right side. Touchdown, Philadelphia. Miles Sanders. His third touchdown of the game, his eighth on the year. And the Eagles are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead. Elliott good on the extra point, and the lead now to three touchdowns at 21.
Saints 7, Jake Elliott to kick off for Philadelphia.
Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. They did what they had to do to start this third quarter, went down, got the touchdown to cut the lead, but the matching touchdown a moment ago, and we're right back where we started at halftime.
Yeah, you're exactly right, partner. They had a little bounce in their step after scoring that first touchdown, but the defense gave one up, and that's the problem right now. Can they get better play from their defense while they continue to score on offense?
He's airing it out for Williams. And he drops it incomplete, and their struggles continue here.
An attempted a deep ball there. They didn't get it. But, boy, they're going to need a few of those to actually hit in order to get back into this game.
Good thing they do have a little bit of time here still left in the contest. Decent-sized deficit, but not one that they can't manage. On third down, he'll drop to throw. Going right side here, and that's complete. And he is finally out of bounds, but not before taking it down inside the 30. A big-time play there for New Orleans. Now look, you're not going to be able to get this all back at once, but that certainly helps.
So you're saying 3 yards in a cloud of dust, not the strategy?
I go aerial attack.
Yeah, I think that's what has to happen. And if you're going to run it, you need to break off big chunks. We just saw a big play right there. They need plenty of those.
And Kamara with a carry there on first down as he works his way forward for a pickup of four.
But that call makes sense because they've been throwing it well on this drive, and once again they show passing formation, showing the shotgun. Then they ran out of it. That was a nice play by them defensively, though, to hold it to a short gain.
The run got four. Now they deal with a second and six. Again, it's Kamara. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. So after the run by Kamara, now another first and 10. And to give this time to the tailback. And he'll be brought down this time at the 5-yard line. 6 yards on that last play. Here's second and four. Now a handoff. Here's Kamara. And not a whole lot there. He does get a couple, taking it from the 5 down to the 3. So a decent deficit at this stage in the second half, 4-down territory?
No doubt about it. There's not a chance that he hasn't looked ahead and said, okay, if we gain yardage on this play, this is what we'll do going forward. If we lose yardage, this is the play call that I'll have ready.
Trying to keep the drive going here. This is play number 7 on 3rd and 2. Let's go, let's go. And he gets halfway there, down to the 1-yard line. He needed two, he got one, and that's going to leave him with 4th down and a yard. Set up to throw. That's to his running back. Complete. Touchdown! Alvin Kamara, his 2nd touchdown of the afternoon. And the Saints are able to cut into this deficit here in the final minute of the 3rd. Extra point right down the middle. And the lead will be cut down to 14.
Saints 14.
kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. And they hit the home run last drive. One play on the ground all the way to the house. Now the defense, maybe they're expecting a run here.
Partner, I love your description, because when we talk about hitting the home run, we usually think about a passing play, aren't we? Something in the air, deep ball. But how about them just taking it? Big time jaunt. Now if you're coming back out, now they've established this run game, the play-action pass could very well be open.
Now a throw out to his fullback is complete. He's going to be dropped following a pickup of 7 past the 30 to the 32.
And there's a third down.
So they'll get a little extra time to come up with his third down play as we play three quarters. This is the National Football League on EA Sports. Eagles on third down. A perfect 4-for-4 thus far. This time it's 3rd and 3. Back to throw, Watson. That's swung out wide to Sanders. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44.
Partner, I like that they're staying aggressive on offense, because to me, this drive is what is known as a put-away drive. You score here, that might put this one to bed. I like the fact that they're playing with confidence and not playing with fear.
On first down, Sanders. And he'll work this forward for about 3 at second down.
Brandon, I've got to think this offensive line has got some smiles on its faces. And I know it sounds crazy, but they practiced for this back in training camp. They knew they'd be in situations where it'd be extra defenders in the box coming after them, trying to keep them from locking down a game. Right now, they want to show the world they're up to the challenge.
Second down, back to Sanders. And he's going to take this across the 50 and into Saints territory. Still about 3 yards shy of a first as the 4-yard pickup brings it to third down. Watson now to throw. And that is incomplete.
Quarterbacks work all the time on manipulating a defense with their eyes and their head movement. In this case, he just stared the receiver down. That allowed for excellent coverage, able to knock that one away.
And with things looking pretty good on the scoreboard, they're going to keep the offense out there and go for it here on 4th. He finds his tight end, Goddard. That's complete. And unable to break away. They stop him a few yards shy. The Eagles unable to convert there on 4th. And this defense is going to get the football back near midfield, right at the 48. Getting set for their next drive, the New Orleans offense. And for them, a touchdown their last go-around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked, but you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
81 yards rushing for him now as he has been tremendous all day long. Staying on the ground on first with Kamara. And this one's going to go the wrong way. Losing yardage back at the 42. Call it a full 3 yards in the wrong direction there. Brings up second down.
I think this offense, specifically this running game, they're going to have to find a way to turn the page, because they haven't found a way to run it effectively thus far, and it's cost them.
After the loss, they'll come up 2nd and 13. Back to throw. And that falls to the ground incomplete. A nice job of bodying him up defensively. And now it brings up 3rd down. The Saints on 3rd down. 3-for-7 so far in this game. This is going to be 3rd and 13. They'll look to throw here. It's complete to Williams. And he can only manage to take the football to the 40, and that is well shy of the first down marker. 2 yards is all they'll get on the completion. It's fourth down. As expected, they're going for it to keep the drive alive. Now that'll be tipped and intercepted. Picked by Tarvarius Moore. And what a return as he brings this all the way back down to the 20-yard line.
Well, I guess an interception at this point on fourth down is just as bad as an incomplete pass. Either way, the ball goes over to the other side.
Yeah, it's a tough spot to be in this late in the game, and there's not a whole lot he could do there. And he winds up giving the ball away.
They'll run on first down. It's Sanders. And he's brought down after a very nice gain.
And carries like that, that's how they're going to continue to salt this thing away here, Charles, in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, how about that? A new set of downs. Clock continues to move. No better way to close out a game than to tap those mastodons you have up front and say, guys, keep pounding them. Let's keep the ball, keep their offense on the sidelines, and let's close this one out.
Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Hall. And he'll go backwards, losing yardage to the 5. So that'll go as a 4-yard loss on the play. And that'll make it 3rd and goal.
They completed the screen on the perimeter, but boy, that was textbook defense. Exactly as you're taught to play against a wide receiver screen, and they snuffed it out for a loss of yardage.
Now they'd really like to make the short field pay off. We'll see if they can, but this is 3rd and goal.
They'll try to run with Sanders. No gain on the play that time, so a big stop, and it's going to leave him with a 4th and goal.
Maybe I'm wrong, but it looked like even if he had opted to keep that, I don't think there was going to be much to gain.
Seemed like it was perfectly defense. You know what they say? Those guys on the other side, they get paid too.
The kick by Elliott is good.
So after 4 touchdowns in the game for this offense, this time they're forced into taking the 3.
But you did mention 4 touchdowns, right? So 4 out of 5, not too bad. I think that's a pretty good record for them.
And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone. So we will start here at the 25. The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started.
We certainly had a sense coming in here that these guys were in for a tough one on the road. That has been how this ball game has played out. They trail big as we continue on now here in this fourth quarter.
Oh, that's one to warm the hearts of all those old school football players, isn't it? Tough, hard, gritty run, got behind his pads, bowled over a few people. Look at that one, right up the gut.
So after 3 quarters, no reason to lighten up now. Looking long for Thomas. And that is incomplete.
This defense was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it.
They've got the lead, 4th quarter. Maybe can expect more passes like that downfield. 33. He'll try again with the arm here on 2nd down. And this is caught. A spectacular one-handed grab there. And they're able to work this to the 25 before it's all said and done. A big play that time through the air. 39 yards. So it's Saints football as we get you reset. They've got a 1st and 10 as they search for a late score. Flag comes in. This might be a free play. Caught left side, Williams. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. So with the completed pass and the yardage they got, they'll decline the penalty.
So obviously, more yards on the pass completion than they would have gained with the penalty. They did the math. They did it well, and it works for them.
They'll look to throw here on 1st down. Looking left side and completing it to Thomas. And he's able to get this down to the 5-yard line before he's out of bounds. A gain of 6 there on 1st.
Brings up 2nd and 4.
from the 5, second and 4.
They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. And nothing but daylight ahead. He's at the 50. He's at the 30. 10. And he takes this one back into the end zone. And the Eagles defense gets a pick 6 TD.
And that one will pretty much erase any hopes of a fourth quarter comeback.
With emphasis, interception, return for touchdown. Door closed, locked, reinforced.
Elliott Good with a PAT, and the lead is now 24. So they throw the pick 6. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. They'll elect to bring it out here from the end zone. And he will be brought down here inside the 20. Good coverage as he's dropped at the 17.
They're on 17-yard line.
Getting set for their next drive, the New Orleans offense. Well, I think that the folks here had hoped that maybe this home atmosphere would carry their guys to a surprise victory, but it does not appear that that's going to be the case. There's too much to handle on the other side in this one. Second down, and it's Kamara again. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. Now they're going to be dealing with a 3rd and 7. Is that one officially a loss of 1?
Brings up 3rd and 7.
A man who's been busy this afternoon, it's Kamara again. And he's going to lose yardage here, back to his own 18. That'll make it 4th down after a loss of 1.
Oh, partner, that play brought back memories, watching them string it out, letting the runner get all the way to the sideline area, but not letting him get out of bounds. They formed that picket fence and didn't allow him through.
Not only that, got him for a loss as well here. And one of the reasons they lead in the fourth quarter, plays like that.
Yeah, it took a little more time off the clock, making them do it that way, didn't they?
And the punt team on now as this one's sent away. Fielded at the 43. It'll wind up just a 35-yard punt, no return. And control of the football switching hands here with very little time remaining in this contest. It's in the fourth quarter down in Miami. And give that one to the Cardinals as they wind up winners. A victory there would mean their 6th on the year. It's a victory here for the Philadelphia Eagles.